If you're serious about building your website, you definitely don't want to rush it. This is why it's such a great idea to consider building your WordPress website locally, giving you convenience and flexibility. In our last lesson, we looked at Local WP, a graphical user interface application for managing your local WordPress sites. If though you're someone who likes to look under the hood and see what's going on, you might prefer the stack-based solution. Hi, I'm Ryan. Thanks for joining us at the Learning Hub. If you haven't yet, be sure to check out the other videos in this series. In this video, we're going to take a look at XAMPP and walk through installing it on your system. You might remember back in lesson 8, we spoke about the different types of local development environments available. And when it comes to stack-based, there are a bunch that all rhyme with AMP. Well, XAMPP is the cross-platform solution that allows us to install the stack of necessary tools required to get us up and running with a local server environment, all on your local computer. To get started, we can simply search for XAMPP in Google. The actual domain is apachefriends.org. Once the page is loaded, click on the Downloads tab. You will notice here there are a bunch of options available. Scroll to your local operating system and I'd recommend downloading the version that includes either PHP version 7.3 or 7.4. If you're on a Mac, be aware that it's a little hard to tell, but there are now two different versions of XAMPP for Mac. The top three here are the normal installers, however the bottom three are actually the virtual machine option. If you're unsure which version you should download, it's worth checking out what version of PHP WordPress currently recommends. You can easily find this out by heading over to wordpress.org/about/requirements. Here you'll see the current recommended version, taking away any guesswork. So I'm downloading version 7.4.22. Once you've downloaded the app, follow the on-screen instructions to install. Now, I'm not making any changes to my setup, just installing XAMPP with the default settings. Once it's installed, we're prompted to launch XAMPP. Let's head over to the Manage Service tab and click Start All. When they all turn green, we can go back to our Welcome tab and hit the Go to Application button. This will launch our default XAMPP application web interface. Now, when it comes to creating your WordPress website in XAMPP, there's no real one-click installer to do all the work for us. Instead, we do need to manually install WordPress. If you haven't done this kind of thing before, it may seem a little intimidating, but if you're game, bear with me because it's honestly not that difficult. The process will give us a glimpse into how WordPress as an application actually works. First thing we're going to do is create our database. From the XAMPP web dashboard, click on the PHP My Admin link. As we know, WordPress relies on a database to store all of its settings and content. Let's click on the Databases tab, and under the Create Database section, add your new database. Give it a name that matches your website. I want to call mine Ryan's Recipes. Click Create, and our blank database has been created. Next step is for us to create a directory or folder where we're going to install WordPress. Back in our XAMPP app, click on the Open Application Folder button. This takes us to the root directory where XAMPP looks for all of our websites. The base folder we're looking for is called htdocs. What we want to do here is create a subfolder inside htdocs. So let's quickly create a folder and give it the name of our website. I'm calling mine Ryan's Recipes. From here, we need to download a copy of WordPress and extract the entire contents into our new folder. So let's head to wordpress.org. Simply click Get WordPress and then click the Download button. Once WordPress is downloaded, let's locate the archive, unzip the files, select all, and drag everything into our new folder. From here, back in our browser, we can navigate to our newly created directory. To do this, we use XAMPP's localhost and follow it with the name of our WordPress directory. So for my example, the address would be localhost/Ryan's Recipes. Our WordPress files will kick into gear and direct us to the WordPress installer. Click Let's Go. Unless you made further changes in PHP MyAdmin, the default username here will be root and the password will be blank. Remembering that because we're working locally, security isn't a huge issue, so having a blank password isn't a concern. Let's hit submit. Now, depending on your system, this could work flawlessly. But for some of you, like me, you might find that you don't currently have the correct file permissions for the WordPress installation to be able to write to its configuration file. So we need to manually make this change. If this is you, we need to copy the configuration settings here to our clipboard. Then let's head back to our WordPress directory and locate the file wp-config-sample.php. Let's firstly rename this file to wp-config.php. Then let's open this file with our text editor on our system. Once it's open, we need to select the entire contents and paste our config to replace it all. Save our file and head back to the browser. Now we can hit run the installation. And now we're on the home stretch. All we need to do is give our WordPress site a name, set up our admin user, and hit install WordPress. And that's it. From here, we can log in and begin building. Obviously, there's a fair bit more involved than we saw with the GUI apps, but I do love how we get to see some of the inner workings and gain a basic understanding of what goes on in the background. So this brings us to the end of this lesson. There is one more lesson in this course, and we're going to be bringing everything that we've learned together, so it's definitely one not to be missed. As always, if you haven't yet, make sure you join Elementor's vibrant community and check out the Academy and blog. Catch you in lesson 11.